their point. قالوا عدم الحفظ. Many people, how many times we hear? We heard the entire Quran, right? We heard the entire Quran here in Taraweeh, for example. Alhamdulillah, we finished the Quran. We heard all of it. Just an example, but how much do we know of the Quran? Varies from person to person. Somebody very little, somebody little. Why? Because we do not. Same thing. We heard a lot of hadith, a lot of you know pieces of knowledge, but because we do not study it. قالوا العلم صيف يعني ولن تأخذه حتى تربطه. يعني if somebody hunts and exerts all the effort to hunt, and then what? You got the deer already. It's in your hand, and then you leave it. That's it. This is what we do all the time. You attend classes like this, for example. But you do not tie it. You tie your hand so that you get it. How you tie knowledge? Record it down. You have record it down and revise it. And this is how you keep it. This is how you reserve it and preserve it, right? So you hifz meaning not only to memorize. Memorizing is very important, but also to record it and have a record and everything. You know, not only reading by eye reading or you know at sight reading. No, you read, understand, and also record down. قال وعدم نشره وتعليمه. A lot of us, they get a lot of knowledge. Everybody, by the way, got even a piece of knowledge, even one single ayah, the knowledge of one ayah, the knowledge about anything. Why don't you spread it to others? Why don't you extend it to others? If you do not extend it to others, probably you would forget it or you would not do it. When you extend it, we just mentioned knowledge. When you spend out of it, it's going to go bigger, it's going to increase. So you spend out of it, you teach to others, you'll be good at it. Like Brother Nazim, mashallah, he went to Egypt, he studied Arabic, very beautiful, mashallah. Probably if he is coming and praying every day like this and he is not, khalas, he would forget. But now he's teaching Arabic to others, mashallah. So it works, you know, he is beneficial to others, and at the same time he is refreshing his knowledge, right? Mm-hmm. He's refreshing his knowledge because he needs also to do what?
Helping.
Yeah, you're helping others, and he is helping himself, and he is, you know, rising in knowledge, mashallah. قالوا وعدم العمل به. The very important part of it is you do not work or act upon your knowledge. You do not use it. So if you don't use it, you lose it. You don't use it, you lose it. Yes, if you don't use knowledge, خلاص, it's not that. قالوا وقيل العلم يهدف بالعمل فإن أجابه وإلا ارتحل. فما استدر العلم واستجلب بمثل العمل به. العلم يهدف بالعمل. Knowledge calls action. Everyday knowledge calls action. فإن أجابه, if it answers, if action answers, like if the person would act on it, okay, knowledge is going to stay. Otherwise, it's going to leave. If there's no action, it's going to leave. فما استدر العلم واستجد بمثل العمل. Nothing can keep and preserve and make you acquire knowledge action, like working according to it. قالوا, that's why, wallahi, and I remember some of my shuyukh, when we study Quran, I read to them, they used to stop by one ayah and say, Sheikh Ahmed, this is going to be your assignment. Inshallah, this week, until next week, you come back to me, you are going to practice this ayah. And you are daraqib on yourself. You are watching over yourself. Like, I remember he said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, I was reading to my shaykh, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنَ. What does it mean? قولوا, say, لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنَ. You guys, you believers, say good to people. He said, خلاص, this is your assignment for this. Do not say any bad thing to anybody this week. Because Allah said, وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنَ. Now we memorize the Quran. It's not only that we memorize it. You go. This is your assignment. Next week or next time, you're going to give me something else. So we have to work. And the Sahaba of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi, the companions, they used to, this is how we used to study or memorize Quran. They get it like 5 ayat by 5 ayat or 10 ayat by 10 ayat. And they said, قالوا, we used not to pass these 5 or 10 ayat until we know them, understand them, and act on them. We apply them into our life. Then we move to the next 5 or 10 ayat. And very important, one of the very important thing about knowledge is you have to have a sheikh. You have to have
teacher.
Because قالوا من كان شيخه كتابه كان خطأه أكثر من صواب. من كان شيخه أو شيخه أو كتابه كان خطأه أكثر من صوابه. If your teacher is gonna be your book, then the mistakes you're gonna do gonna be more than the correct things. You're gonna make more mistakes because you cannot just go to a book and like this. Nobody even do it. Nobody does this. Nobody just, you know, even if in the online courses, you should have a time to access to a teacher so that you have interaction when ask questions and so on. But just to get a book of knowledge and go study it and get, no, it doesn't work like this. You have to have a sheikh. قَالُوا وَمَلْدَى شَيْخَ لَهُ فَشَيْخُهُ الشَّيْطَانِ. If somebody doesn't have any sheikh, then his sheikh is shaitan. Shaitan is a sheikh because he's gonna misunderstand everything. You need to have somebody to have, you know, a clue about these complicated, sometimes complicated thing. وقال الدقاق الشجرة التي تنبت وحدها لا تثمر. The tree that just grows by itself is not gonna have any fruit. If you think you're gonna grow like this in this color by yourself, you'll not have any fruit. Because a tree that comes in the middle of the desert by itself is not gonna be fruitful. وإن أثمرت فإن ثمرها بغير لك. Even if it got some fruit, it's gonna be like what? Very not ripe fruits. If it's not gonna be have some pollens or so on, you see. So this you have to have this knowledge from a sheikh.
قال نرجو له يعني أن يكون من أهل العلم ظاهرا وباطنا.
We hope that the person who would read the sheikh in the book, Sheikh Nizaid, he said we hope that the person who does this, he would be from the people of knowledge ظاهرا وباطنا, inwardly and outwardly. If he studies, if the person who studied was in this book. And sincerely and so on, and have faith in it, we hope that he will have knowledge and he will be good inside and outside. طيب, let me change the time. Yeah, I think the time is over, subhanAllah. Didn't even get to update Islam, the pillars of faith. خلاص, inshallah, we start next time from the pillars of faith. We stop here. And maybe I promised last time that it's going to be like 10 sessions. I guess it's going to be a little bit more because... we need to. I'm trying to make everything, you know, brief, but subhanAllah, time passes very fast and quick. So inshallah, we start next time from the pillars of Islam or Arkan of Islam, and we have a little bit more, you know, long time, not very long, with the shahadatain, the testimony of faith, because it has many items and many things to mention about it, inshallah. So inshallah, we'll continue next time. This was the conclusion of session 2. It's going to be uploaded to the internet, to YouTube. Inshallah, I'm going to send the link to everybody. Feel free, inshallah, to spread the word and let many other people know. And if you can just hang around to take the attendance after we, right now, inshallah, ta'ala. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alayhi wa sallam. And Allah's peace and blessing be in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa Allah ta'ala ala wa alam. All knowledge is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and any mistake is from myself and from shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us and guide us to the straight path. Ameen wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.